Hello and welcome to Monmouth in Focus, the program about the services and functions of Monmouth County government. I'm Cynthia Scott, your host for this segment of Monmouth in Focus, and I'm joined today by the Monmouth County Prosecutor, Christopher Gramiccioni, here to talk about some veterans programs that you are offering at the Prosecutor's Office. Thanks so much for joining us today.
Happy to be here again today, Cynthia. Nice to see you.
Always happy to see you too. So, Prosecutor, Monmouth County does a lot for veterans, and the Monmouth County Prosecutor's Office recently unveiled a program assisting veterans who have recently been charged with a crime?
That's right. This past summer, we rolled out our Veterans Diversion Program, something that had been in the works for a few years. Kind of had to put the brakes on it for a little while because, as you know, the governor signed legislation enacting Veterans Diversion Programs across the state. Mm-hmm. So we kind of wanted to stand fast and see what his program looked like to make sure we were consistent with it. But we're up and running, and it's been a rousing success so far.
And how does it work?
Well, any veteran that's charged with a crime, upon his or her arrest, there'll be an inquiry whether they served in the military. And after presenting proof of some sort, whether it's a DD-214 or an ID card or veterans card, if they committed a third or fourth degree nonviolent offense, then they'll be eligible to be put in this Veterans Diversion Program. And it's a track, essentially, that instead of just traditional criminal prosecution, if there's a connection with the offense that they committed to some type of mental disease or issue that they might have encountered as a result of their service in the armed forces, they're eligible for this program. And if they satisfy the conditions and requirements of it, then the case could end up being dismissed and the arrest expunged.
Wow, how important is a program like this, Prosecutor? We hear so much about PTSD, veterans coming back from overseas, and it's such an issue and can be such a problem.
It can, and I gotta tell you, this one hits close to home for me. Mm-hmm. I think you all know that I'm a commander in the Navy. I've been deployed, I've seen this stuff firsthand with fellow service members, how they can be affected by mental issues as a result of things they've seen during war or combat. So I think it's really, really important to give them this opportunity, considering that they've served us in such a selfless way. Mm-hmm. And I think it works. We see an average of 22 suicides from members of the military, current or past, a day. I mean,
wow.
that suicide
yeah.
rate in and of
Just
itself
awful.
Is driven in large part by some of the mental challenges that they face coming back from deployments.
Sure. Prosecutor, how exactly does the program work?
Well, if there's an arrest made, and again, it has to be a nonviolent type crime, a third degree or fourth degree, there's a little bit of wiggle room in there with prosecutors having discretion over the program like myself. But if they're accepted into the program, the first thing they do is they have to require some kind of mental health treatment, whether it's through the VA or a private practitioner. And those reports have to be provided to the prosecutor's office on a scheduled basis, once a month, twice a month, to ensure that they're complying with the conditions. Other conditions would include that they have to stay out of trouble, they can't get involved in any other offenses, they have to check in with a pretrial service officer, and they also have to go through what's called a Veterans Transition Initiative. And that's an immersion type program, just 3 days, where during this period they're going to be provided a number of different resources, access to resources for employment, for residency, for things like that. And they're gonna be assigned, and this is an important piece of it, they're gonna be assigned a mentor. And a mentor is gonna be somebody who has served in the armed forces before, who can kind of treat them as a battle buddy of sorts.
Wow.
Trying to shepherd them through this transition as they go through the program. So the idea is not just to walk down a path and have the charges get dismissed, but try to serve holistically the person that was arrested who was a former service member.
And like you said, really try to help them, not just to absolve the charges, but to try to help them get their lives back together, get their lives in order, when maybe they may not have had anywhere else to turn.
That's right. And a lot of times it's a matter of pride. A service member who might be suffering from PTSD, for example, or some other mental disorder, they might feel embarrassed to get help. This program, if it gets one or two people in the door, maybe then hopefully they understand this isn't something to be embarrassed about. You've been through a difficult time. And if we can get them treated in some form or fashion, there's a great, great high rate of recidivism for these people to continue to contribute to society.
Sure. Is there a timetable for the program?
No, it's driven in large part by the evaluations that we get from the treatment providers, whether it's the VA or a private psychologist or psychiatrist that may be treating that member. It would probably run between 1 and 2 years.
Okay.
And as that's done, the charges that are pending against this member, they would essentially be put on the shelf. They wouldn't be brought forward. They wouldn't be pushed through the criminal justice system. And that's why they call it a diversion program. As long as they comply with the conditions of the program, The reward at the end of the rainbow is to be able to dismiss the charge and expunge the arrest. But I think the greater reward is hopefully that through treatment, through a partnership with the Veterans Transition Initiative, we're going to be treating the member himself, not just the crime that they're charged with, but the
individual.
Exactly,
which is so important, because if you're just treating the crime, then they may go out and do it again. If you're treating them emotionally with any sort of issues that they have, they're getting the help they need.
That's exactly right.
What happens with someone who doesn't comply with the program?
If they fail to comply with the terms, then they would be thrown out of the Veterans Diversion Program and they'd go back to the traditional criminal justice track. But you know, we're working on that. I mean, the idea is to be firm with the conditions, but at the same time, we don't want to be obstinate. So it's going to take a lot of dialogue with their treatment provider to make sure that it's something that would cause them to have to be jettisoned from the program.
And it's relatively new now, so it's difficult to kind of gauge how well it's doing so far. But what do you expect out of it?
I believe, and I've seen programs like this across the country, and I think there's about 30 of them in 30 different states. Mm-hmm. And I've seen that when people go through a diversion program like this, who was a former service member, the rate of recidivism is very, very low. They come back and they contribute to society. Mm-hmm. These people generally they're not extensive criminals, and that's one thing. If they have an extensive criminal history, you wouldn't be eligible for the program.
Right.
It's just they've been through something so traumatic, so difficult, and there's a lot of folks that have with the wars we've fought over the last couple decades. My hope is that it's going to be a rousing success.
They can't get their lives in order on their own. They need the help to do it.
That's right. And they just need to know that there's people that can support them. Mm-hmm. And that's the great thing about this program and Monmouth County Veterans Services, which we're working in partnership with.
And Prosecutor, I can tell that you have a passion for this program, not just as the prosecutor, but really on a personal level as well.
Absolutely. Like I said, I'm a commander in the Navy. I've been in for 16 years now. I've deployed to Afghanistan myself. I've had a chance to see operators, service members go through this, and I think it's one of the most important things I can do in my term here as prosecutor.
Sure, absolutely. And if you could just help one person, even, it's worth it.
You got that right, Cynthia.
Yeah. Oh, thanks so much for joining us, Prosecutor. And obviously, to spread the word out, we can go to your website. We could also go to www.visitmonmouth.com to find out the most information and the most valuable information about this program. I'm Cynthia Scott. Have a great day, everyone.